Welcome back guys to my YouTube channel. Today I'm back at my YouTube channel with another redstone build. Today I think my redstone video will be a bit longer because I'll be talking about a very serious thing. So in front of us is a piston door, as you can see. It's massive, it's extremely massive, using tons upon tons of observers. Because after they released observers into the game, everything is upon observers now. Like every redstone contraption is now depending upon observers. So this one's also. Now you may have guessed, it's a 4x4 piston door. Now what may be special about a 4x4 piston door, and why is the redstone so big for a 4x4 piston door? Well, what you may is not seeing is the backside of the piston door. The backside of the piston door is extremely satisfying to see. Like, let me show you. In 3, 2, 1, boom. It's a double-sided 4x4 piston door. There are iron blocks on both sides. You must be shocked, right? Most of you aren't, because this must be seeming so easy redstone for you guys. And you guys must have been saying, ah, well, I can do that extremely easily. Well, you are thinking wrong. Making a 4x4 double-sided piston door in Bedrock Edition just literally killed me. I have just trying to do this for like more than 15 days over, and I haven't found a single contraption that works 100% of the time. You guys may know that there are pretty good redstoner in our community, Bedrock community. They might manage to do it, but I didn't. So here's a normal 4x4 piston door. There's absolutely no fail chances with this one, as this one is only single-sided. Like don't get me wrong, why is this so slow? I built it when I just started playing Minecraft, in Minecraft 1.15 version. Honey blocks were just introduced into the game, and it's one of the fifth or sixth build I made in this world. Like back then, like I was extremely new. I didn't even knew what are comparators, so like you can know how back I made this thing, and I was so proud of myself that I made it a 4x4 honey and slime piston door which slides from the side. Well, this was very satisfying for me to watch, though it's extremely fucking slow, and now we can develop 10,000 times faster than this thing. This is no fail chance, okay? But whenever you come to the back, this absolutely looks pathetic. This really looks extremely bad from the back. Like there are honey and slime. It seriously looks extremely bad. So what redstoners nowadays do is, they're very pro redstoner. They don't use this on the back. Even on the back they have iron. And even on the front. Now you must be guessing, how is that possible? And you know, it's possible, seriously possible. Let me show you. It's the retraction, but remember guys, I couldn't make it to work 100% of the time. Like it has a like 80 to 90% work rate. Like this time it worked, but it may not work all the time. But why I have still kept this design, and I'm still showing you this design, because there's a very special purpose behind it. This one slides from the side. And as there are blocks on the way to power this thing, this is extremely hard to power. Like see. on a normal double piston extender, you have 3 ticks over here, 6 tick over here, and 1 tick, 0 tick over there. It kind of works like this. But now in this design we cannot do this. Like, let me demonstrate you. Are you gonna do this? Seriously. Are you gonna do this, huh? And if you place blocks here, when it will go to retract, this will break the circuit. So this is not actually possible. But you now may be thinking, how the hell I'm making this possible? Because we are powering it from the above or from the below. Let me demonstrate you how. We are using obsidian below the slime block. Something like this. I think I did something wrong with it. Yeah, we are using something like this to make this double-sided piston door possible. But again, remember, this is a 4x4 piston door, so you cannot do it just like this, man. You need to have more blocks. You need to have 12 blocks for per side retraction. You may be thinking that's it, right? No, that's not it. Now that's it. Sorry, we need to have obsidian there. You may be thinking, this is 12 blocks. How will you extend the double extender? The guy with redstone skills. Well, I still have the answer to that. Well, if this doesn't work, we can have a piston here. We can have a piston. But then it makes something like this. Now explain me, Redstone. How are you gonna do fix this? So just see my struggle. This is so many problems I have to deal with to just make this piston door work. Now you guys are still gonna comment toxic like, "Oh, well, that's very easy. I can also do it. Just try doing it." Your head will just start to break down. I'm just going through mental repression after just making the piston door in front happen. It has a very rare chances of occurring in this platform. Well, in the Java version, it works all of the time. But in Bedrock, due to crashing its stone circuit, it doesn't work. Then we need to only do it with a monostable circuit attached. And if you do it like this, it has a very low chance of working. Like right now it may work, but it may not also work all of the time. Well, this time my luck is good. I think this time it's working. Well, this physics is just being applied over here. We are pushing the blocks, the first group in front, and then the whole piston extender is just extending. Like it cannot depend on its own. It's working with other. Plus, when you are making redstone contraption like this, you will just blow your head with the redstone time ticking. Like my hair is just blown up, setting up all of the ticks. Like it took me like 10,000 hours just to set up the ticks, like which repeater will be on which tick. So this is actually only one part of it. We need to build four of them in groups. See what I was talking about? This error. Now I had to deal with this error a lot, like 10,000 times. This is a bug. This is a serious bug which actually makes blocks out of sticky piston go somewhere else. See, I hate this bug. There's a very rare chances of it working, and now my battery is just dying because I have worked on this project for 1,000,000 hours. See? Are you just seeing my struggle? Like this is how many times it happens. So that is why I just needed to like do this every time. But there's still a chance of this happening. So what I did is that I improved it with redstone repeat timed and with a rising edge monostable circuit pushing it extremely quickly. Just one ticking it. See, my just head just gets busted, like it just like blasts into flames when this happens. Well, people returning to redstone communities have no respect though, by the way, like no one actually likes redstone. Everyone just wants to be green, like they want to build things other than doing redstone. Like, who sees my video? No one sees. So this is actually one part of it, and we need to make four of them, and just the spitting out bug is what I needed to deal with 10,000 times. You guys may be thinking because I just made it in front of you, so it's very easy. You guys must be thinking that as I have built it in front of you, this must be very easy, right? No. Because I needed my time to design it, and if you would have designed it, you would have designed it in another way. Which won't have worked. Like, for me it also is the same. It took me millions hours to make it work. Let me tell you the secret. Why is it working so perfectly here? We are using something as a dual-edged monostable circuit, like which pulses both time on the second piston. Like something like this. And we have also a piston there. He died. Is descend the zone board because we need a piston there. See, that's how you're making it work. Like, the circuit is kind of like this, which we're implementing here. It pulses the second piston twice. As you can see, successful double snake tender. With now like this design has a low chances of failing. And yeah, the retraction must be slow and very noisy. But still, I said it's not completely working. It's working only couple times, like it has a 70% chance of working. No, sorry, it's 80 to 90. And this is the bug which I'm talking about, repeater timings. Like I set every repeater on like 10,000 times, but still doesn't figure out which repeater will win this time. So see my struggle. And after millions of try, I got it. See, this one will 2 tick, this one on 3 tick, and this is the circuit. It worked. So now that's how you make it possible. See, this is the 1/4 of the complete piston door. But still it has a chance of failing. So this is how many problems I needed to deal with while making this piston door. So this is my piston door now. See, I deserve respect plus plus for this. Like I have tried for millions out just to make this work. I hope you will see my struggle, I know. See, sometimes while retracting it, it is about to do the mistake, but it doesn't because of the fast retraction. Okay, let's close it for now, and I will show you another design which I have designed. This one has a pretty 99% chances of working. Now if you guys follow my YouTube, you must be seeing I have designed a piston door like this before, which is a 4x4 single sided honey and slime piston door design, which actually slides from up and down, which is also actually very satisfying, but I don't like it that much. But the special perk about this is again a double sided piston door, 4x4. Then now you must be saying, why am I showing this about like half an hour later starting the video? This is because I don't like the design that much. I just like the one which slides from the side. As for the proof, it's double-sided. First-sided, double-sided. And the extension and retraction extremely works. It works. And it's extremely quick and 0% chances of failing.
That was my calling bell. Don't get scared. Now you must be saying, how are you powering the second piston this time? With movable redstone power. Well, we are using this thing, and as this, we are working it with a double piston extender like this. That's why we don't need the piston power pushing the first group of blocks. See, we are using this design. See, this is the circuit. This is what we are using for the one side. Like this is expandable design, you can expand it at your will. Like as you can see here. You're using a very clever technique here. And don't worry, I haven't stealed the design from anyone. This is my design, I designed it. Yeah, this is the fun part. If you stand on this, you will be just thrown into the sky. Sometime you may not, but sometime you will. And if you want to build in double sided piston, well, just build this. Don't build that one which I showed over there, because that one's extremely laggy slow. But still keep this design, because I only love the one which just comes from the side. Like, it's really satisfying to watch. This one also satisfying, but like not my favorite design. You know, we all restaurant have their own way to do something. Like Mambo will never use a lever for on his suppose in his hermit craft base. He will obviously use T flip flop. You know, redstoners. They like to do redstone everywhere. Well, this one's lighting quick. Even on the extension, even on the retraction. So that was the redstone video for today, guys. I hope you guys have loved my video. And if you love my video, please comment that if you want any tutorials on one of even one of them, I'll surely show it. Can you see my dance moves?